What's up, ladies and gentlemen? Ross the Boss coming at you with an all-new Let's Play StarCraft II Wings of Liberty.
Well, you fought real good out there, Tychus. Your time in the freezer didn't dull your edge none.
Well, fear and violence always did bring out the best in me.
Have to admit, we always did make a good team.
Yeah. Well, that was until I went to prison and you went legit.
Right.
All right, well, let's check out the UNN news broadcast. We have some new research opportunities as well.
This is Kate Lockwell reporting from UNN headquarters on Korhal. Let's go to Donnie Vermillion on special assignment.
Kate, I'm very pleased to be talking to General Horace Warfield. General, I understand that Dominion forces will soon be showing off their newest weapon, the Odin War Machine.
That's correct, Donnie. We'll show the Odin on the streets of Korhal itself, with full coverage from your fine network.
General, Kate Lockwell here. I've heard rumblings about some sort of logistics trouble with the Odin's debut.
Now, Kate.
It's true, Kate. The Odin was delayed in shipping. And we briefly lost communication with the production facility. But it arrived safely, so we can go ahead with the unveiling.
You heard it here first. The Dominion unveiling new weapons of destruction on the streets of Korhal.
What is wrong with that woman? Tell her not to interrupt my interviews!
Your boy Horner is actually pulling this off. Gotta say, I'm mighty impressed.
Let's check out and see what Tychus has to say.
So how does the Odin rate as a fighting machine?
Brother, it is the single greatest creation in the history of mankind. Striding around and dispensing righteous fury just about brought a tear to my eye. You just let me know when I can take it out for another spin.
You'll get your chance soon enough, old buddy. Don't you worry.
And we are going to visit the laboratory, check out our new Zerg research. We should be able to get our new Psi emitter. Mr. Raynor, you have obviously reached the limit of what you can learn from Zerg biosamples. We would be happy to purchase any future samples you find for 10,000 credits per sample. Check this console if you find any further biosample, and the funds will be instantly wired to your account. We, of course, do have our ability, the Hive Mind Emulator. This will permanently mind control Zerg units, which could be very useful. But personally, I think I'm going to get the defensive structure. The Psi Disruptor will not only slow the movement speed, but it will also slow the attack speed of all nearby Zerg units. And I will certainly be taking this. And, of course, we now have current research level 25 on Zerg and 25 on the Protoss. Let's check out the new Zerg tank as well. This is getting absolutely massive. The sample is trying to escape. I've detected several new acids in the nutrient solution over time. They will crack the tank. I wonder if Commander Raynor can post some Marines down here. No, he'll want to destroy it. I haven't learned everything I can from this thing yet. Breakthrough. I dosed some tissue with concentrated sigma radiation, and it slowed growth and movement severely. It would take a lot of work to safely deploy that much radiation on the battlefield, but it might be worth it. Another breakthrough, and this one scares me. I mapped my way through the DNA of some brain tissue, peering back thousands of years, and I isolated the strain from which the Zerg Overmind was derived. Not enough to clone the Overmind, but I would follow the strand to gain insight into how it controlled the Zerg. Very, very neat. Let's check out the armory. We have 130,000 credits. See what Swan has to say.
So, Swan, what are the chances we can build something like that Odin?
You nuts? No way we've got the facilities for mass-producing hardware on that scale.
And here I was thinking you could build anything, Swan.
Cute. All right, forget the scale. I'm gonna figure it out, don't you worry. And I'll come up with something a damn sight more practical than that showpiece. You see if I don't.
All right. So now that we have I guess we don't have Thor's unlocked just yet. Let's check out our Wraiths. Start with 100 energy and evade 20% of incoming attacks while cloaked. Check out the Dominion once again. I wouldn't mind gaining 2 range and 3 sight radius on all ghosts. But then again, I also wouldn't mind improving our Banshee's cloak ability. Or even improving our Viking missile range and cannon range. I want all of these. I guess that's a little unfortunate. And of course, I do want fire suppression system. I believe what I'm going to do is improve our Viking missile range and cannon range. And we need 80,000 plus 85,000. And the next mission, I'm going to check out our bridge. See what Horner has to say.
Sir, when Tychus came back aboard the ship, I had the techs run a scan on him.
Matt, you need to get a hobby.
Seriously, sir. His suit contains a sophisticated transponder. If it receives the correct code, it'll shut down all his major organs. That suit is a death trap.
He's got a gun to his head.
And who's got their finger on the trigger? Mobius?
Tychus, what have you gotten yourself into?
And of course, like I still believe, I think it is Emperor Minx. But you know, I really can't recall. We aren't necessarily going to do our star map just yet. We are going to head into the laboratory and do another Protoss mission. Echoes of the future.
To our ruined homeworld of Ire. The Zerg infestation still covered much of our beloved world. The desiccated remains of the Overmind were still there. A grim reminder of battles lost and battles won.
We are diving into the echoes of the future.
I remember the fall of Ire. Don't much like the idea of having to see it all again. Guess there's nothing for it.
At the very apex of its victory against us, the Zerg Overmind grew overconfident. Now, all that was left of the mighty Overmind was a twisted, withered husk. I needed to understand whatever memories lingered within the creature's rotting mass. Only by making contact with the gargantuan tendrils connected directly to its cortex could I learn its secrets. Yet its countless minions, which seemed to be feeding from its dead husk, would prove somewhat problematic.
All right, well, we are going to be diving into the echoes of the future. Flying units are effective at exploring the map and identifying threats before your army arrives. Wouldn't mind checking out some of the Protoss air units. I wouldn't mind having a carrier either. Those are absolutely amazing and a little expensive as well.
I must find a way to establish a foothold and summon reinforcements to keep the Zerg at bay. This faithful observer has kept watch since the evacuation. Its abilities will certainly prove useful now.
And of course, we now have an observer. They are permanently cloaked. And they also have the ability to detect invisible or burrowed Zerg units. I believe it's, invisible or burrowed.
Shozak Makbo. I will fulfill my calling.
And we have one over here as well.
En Arudin Ashagal.
Wouldn't mind going up that hill, but I think we're going to go here for the objective.
Some of these abandoned structures remain functional. We shall make use of them. This ancient beacon still thrums with power. I wonder,
Oh, man. Gonna love some of these.
I've heard tales of the mighty colossi sealed away beneath Ire. The beacon must have awoken these fearsome guardians. The Zerg perceive a threat to their dead master.
The Colossi can practically obliterate just about anything. Let's construct as many probes as we can.
The Zerg will keep coming until we are dead. I must find the Overmind's cortex and discover what I can from it.
Building some pylons.
You have not enough minerals.
And as soon as these pylons are constructed, we are once again going to begin construction of probes. Now, I believe each pylon will give us about 10 supply. Oh no, it looks like it's actually 8 supply. And of course, our turrets are coming back online. Very, very useful. And it looks like we have some additional minerals.
If we use our observers wisely, we can scout the area before putting ourselves at risk. Ire will be restored. In the servant.
And of course, we're going to continue our production of probes. And possibly even begin harvesting of Vespian gas.
Shozak Machno.
We're gonna scout around, see what's over here. These observers are very, very slow, unfortunately. Looks like we have some additional mineral pallets.
My burdens weigh heavily.
Wouldn't mind producing some zealots as well, producing more and more probes. And let's begin construction, our harvesting of our Vespian gas. Build a stalker as well. And of course, we can begin our upgrades as soon as we have enough resources.
We must be prepared to defend our base. The Zerg are on the move. Honor commands.
It looks like some infested Terran buildings.
My allegiance is yours.
Base is under attack.
Man, these Colossi are absolutely phenomenal. Unfortunately, this Protoss cannon did take damage. We might want to go ahead and upgrade our shielding of all of our buildings and even the armor and weapons as well. Excuse me for a minute. Sorry about that. And of course, Zeratul is taking out more and more minions.
Ire will be restored. Honor commands. In the service of Ire.
And there's no way I'm going to be making any progress over here. For the time being. What I would do for some ghosts right about now be quite useful.
Glory to the I will.
And in the meantime, we're gonna pump out more zealots and begin construction of our ground weapons level 1. Let's produce more probes. Send another probe to harvest or construct an assimilator, and then harvest the Vespian gas. Now, once all of our probes are completed, we should have 14 out of 21 on our mineral harvesting, and I wouldn't even mind getting an additional one as well.
Entara, we are the
I meditate. Command me. I will.
And let's send our observer over this wall. We have an overmind, or an overlord, I should say.
In the service of us. These warp gates appear to be functional. Perhaps there's a chance.
And I believe I am going to produce some additional pylons. Something like this. And of course, let's throw another one in the middle here. And I will be producing another warp gate as soon as I can.
My life for life.
My burdens. We must not hesitate.
I am the voice of the
Eclipse. Gonna be blinking a stalker up as soon as I can.
Beraku.
Unfortunately, they don't do too much damage. They will be upgraded in time. First with their plasma shields, of course. Let's construct some additional stalkers. They will take 42 seconds to produce.
Shozak Makno.
So far, so good.
Upgrade complete.
We have a few extra zealots prepared for our next frenzied attack. And I believe I will go ahead and produce another warp gate as soon as I can.
You have not enough minerals.
I will erase the demons of
And we now have two stalkers. We've upgraded our plasma proton shields. Looks like it's still 80 out of 80, though. I wonder if that even increased it.
I am the voice of the Eclipse.
The Zerg seek to overwhelm us. To arms, my brethren.
You say we move unseen. Very well. Intrigue.
I will be.
And we are going to bring our observer in this direction. Purchasing another stalker, or even two more.
I am here in the shadows.
And 3 seconds until our next invasion. Looks like they're going to be coming from both sides. Do Nihilus worms, or Nidus worms, have the ability to detect cloaked units? Not too sure. Looks like they don't. Make a quick work of that. And of course, Zeratul is going to blink over and take out these worms. And that was very, very easy. Okay, swag.
Honor commands.
All right, so we now have three of these stalkers. Let's bring Zeratul up this direction.
Glory to the
And continue to produce more and more stalkers. We have the ability to transform the warp gate. Upgrades this gateway into a warp gate, allowing it to warp and ground units to any location powered by a pylon or warp prism. That, of course, could be very useful. And we are going to be building a pylon over here.
I am the voice of the Eclipse. I am here in the shadows.
And possibly harvesting our very first tentacle.
En-Arudi, the first overmine tendril. I sense pain, surprise, death.
Let's see if we can find the rest of the tentacles on the map.
We are one with the shadows.
Right now, we only have about 6 stalkers, but that should be quite enough for our endeavors. I would love to get another observer as well.
Aduntorida, Zeratul. We were trapped within the gate's energy matrix when it was deactivated. You have our thanks.
We have a High Templar as well. They once again have the ability to drain energy from the target and create a psionic storm, causing 80 damage to all units in the target area.
You address me?
Very strong.
I will erase the demons of the...
You require.
I will be redeemed.
I'm here in the shadows.
We must not hesitate.
I'm here in the shadows.
And of course, taking out just about everyone here.
We are one.
Looks like we still don't have our very first weapons upgrade. We're working on it though.
Shozak Makro. En-Haldir.
And Zeratul is going to be taking some damage.
You acquire my skills. Intriguing.
All is in jeopardy.
Very wise. You address. State thy bidding. Remove unseen.
And taking out just about everything. Got a Mutalisk up the road. Producing more and more stalkers. We might need some more pylons.
Zerg seek to overwhelm our base.
Finally upgraded our rank 1 weapons. I would love to upgrade to rank 2.
Your war base is under attack.
Let's send Zeratul back to our base. Unfortunately, he is quite slow as well. Use our blink. And it looks like we didn't necessarily take any real damage except for on that tower. In the meantime, the rest of these stalkers will head over to the infested Terran base. And we'll move up the road here.
Shozak Maknol. You address me. Glory. To the first.
All right, so we're gonna blink in and use our void prism.
My allegiance is yours.
I am the cold is the void. For the reckoning. Very wise. Intriguing.
So far, so good.
Very well. We move unseen.
And we did take a little bit of damage, unfortunately.
I heard.
And we are about to reach our second tentacle.
The second overmind tendril. I sense death and joy.
Let our enemy know our fury.
We are producing a Twilight Council and a Robotics Corps. Once we get our Twilight Council up and running, we should be able to produce some additional upgrades.
We embrace the glory of battle.
And we are going to continue to move around the map. We are looking for different obelisks. Not too sure where the other one is. It looks like it's down here. Most likely, at least.
We are one.
Gaining some additional credits from the Zerg research.
You address me.
And of course, about to blink over this ledge and take out whatever we can. Throw a void prism on that overseer.
I am the voice. Cold is the void. Very well.
And let's take out this one as well. We are going to blink in, throw another prism up as well.
my immediate.
Mineral field depleted.
Easy enough.
I serve. I will erase the demons of the past.
And taking out the Overseer, so that way Zeratul does not get damaged.
I will be restored.
We should have the ability to once again upgrade the rest of our units.
My meditation is over.
We are one with the shadows.
And I'm attempting to attack this Banneling.
The Zerg are coming. The third Overmind tendril. I sense satisfaction in a plan set in motion long ago. And fear of the future.
Another frenzied attack very soon.
I am the voice.
We might lose these probes.
We move unseen.
We should be able to hold out long enough.
We embrace.
About to blink in and throw a void prism down. If I can press the right button.
For the reckoning. We are one with the shadows.
And of course, our base is being attacked.
I'm here.
Let's send some of our units up to protect it. I don't believe we're going to lose any buildings.
Very well.
I will be.
And looks like we did lose some pylons, unfortunately. But of course, we do have the ability to produce more. You know, it might be nice to begin construction of, you know, some Protoss cannons.
I'm here in the shadows.
More stalkers coming up.
You require my skills. Voice of the Eclipse. I am the heart of darkness.
Easy enough. Producing some cannons. Two for now. And once again, going back to our forge, upgrading our ground weapons and our shields, and sending Zeratul into the fray. We have one last Overmind tendril. Looks like we have a robotics facility, but we can't seem to find our obelisk. Not too sure where it would be either. Probably somewhere up here.
I will erase the demons of the past.
Let's blink in.
Glory.
Use our void prism, and of course, take out whatever units we can.
My allegiance is yours.
Zeratul does 90 damage. Oh my goodness. And blink on out of there.
And
state thy bidding.
As soon as our void prism is up, we're going to once again do the same thing.
Mineral field depleted.
Very well. He shall be
taking out about anybody and everything. Anybody and everyone, I should say.
The fourth Overmind tendril. I sense an end. I must go to the Overmind cortex to understand.
Why?
Greetings, brother. I speak to you from the beyond. Tassadar, but you died slaying this cursed overmind. I have never tasted death, Zeratul, nor shall I. But that is a tale for another time. I have come to tell you of this creature's courage. Courage? It was an abomination. Not always. The Zerg were altered. A single overriding purpose was forced upon them. The destruction of our people. The Overmind was formed with thought and reason, but not free will. It screamed and raged within the prison of its own mind. Who did this? Why? I know not, but the Overmind found a way to resist its all-consuming directive. It created a chance. A hope of salvation. The Queen of Blades. Madness. Only she can free the Zerg from slavery. And in so doing, save all that is. I do not understand, brother. Forget what you know, Zeratul. The Overmind saw a vision. The end of all things. And now, you must see it too. No. This vision. I cannot bear it. Stop.
Oh man. Echoes of the Future. We have now completed our final objective. Thank you all so much for joining me, and as always, I will see you in our next adventure.